It's me. You know, when I'm an old man, I can barely walk. But like I said before, I'm gonna be able to walk and talk and be strong when I'm older, because one thing about Floyd Mayweather, I'm not going out there to take no punishment. You know, it's not cool with taking punishment. That's not cool. What's cool is to be able to come to the sport, you know, and change the sport and help the sport become a better sport for the young fighters that's up and coming, that comes behind me, years and years behind me also.
Boy, your camp be the same as it was for Guerrero when your dad and Roger split the duties, and then on Fight Night
Road,
dad's be in the corner and Roger take a secondary role?
Well, it's really not splitting the duties. My dad is my trainer. Of course, I feel like if I'm in a position to work with two of the best trainers in the world, why not?
Is Roger's health good enough?
I truly believe so. Of course, I feel like we're in a position to make sure he get the best health. I mean, the best health care. So why not? You know, everything's been working right thus far. So we're going to continue to go out there and do what we do.
Is it the reason I ask, because it worked out so well in the Guerrero fight, having your dad as your head guy, Roger, you know, as your support person.
Is it getting tougher and tougher for you to find opponents that can make these kinds of events and make them interesting?
Well, it's really not that. You know, I got to commend just Leonard and Al and Richard. They do a tremendous job. When I say a tremendous job, as far as, you know, I feel like we look at things long term. When I say long term, as far as, okay, we see a young kid that's, you know, he's a good puncher. You know, he's a solid boxer, and he already has a pretty solid fan base, and he has a country behind him. So we take this guy and say, you know what? We'll put him on the undercard of the biggest guy in the sport. They're right by each other anyway, and the ultimate goal is to build this kid to a level. So, you know, those two can fight and, of course, do crazy numbers. Mm-hmm. Of course, that's the ultimate goal. It's just his business. I understand business, and I think it was a brilliant game plan.
Is there somebody out there, and I think most people are thinking maybe Adrien Broner is like a guy that maybe down the line builds up to that point. Is there someone else out there that you've
got? I mean, you know, I think Adrien
Broner, does Broner fit into that category?
I think, you know, I look at, like I said before, you know, I look at Adrien Broner like Daniel's son. And, you know, I'm Mr. Miyagi, and I tell, you know, we never seen Daniel's son try to go against Mr. Miyagi. So,
Wax on.
I'm proud of Adrien Broner victory. You know, it's a lot of things he still have to learn. It's a lot of things he still have to learn. I mean, I think I feel that he should have got the knockout the other day. You know, and I'm gonna continue to support him. And he was flat footed. And I just feel like with my career, you know, a lot of times they try to compare the two, which, you know, I love the kid, but you got to realize, let's look at my career. Before we get to talking about, you know, I already fought a guy that was so crafty, Engineer Hernandez, at 21 years old.
Yep.
And I feel like in the sport of boxing now, a lot of these guys are fighting guys that's handpicked, which I understand, because this is a business also. And you also have to look at longevity. And so, you know, Corrales, Castillo, and you know, I feel like you're fighting a guy like Paul, and Paul Marginali is a, like I said, he beat all odds. For a guy not to be a big puncher and to become a two-time world champion says a lot about Paulie. Says a lot about Paulie. So I'm proud of him, and his commentating is is unbelievable. And like I said before, I'm proud of him. And Golden Boy, they done a hell of a job with their company. And you know, only thing, like I said before, we're just a company that's, we're a small company, and our ultimate goal is to become, you know, huge someday. But it's good that we can work hand in hand with Golden Boy. And you know, it's not like it was, you know, in the past where we're not like Bob Arum Bob Arum and Don King, where we can't get along. We travel, you know. My sons love Rich's sons, and Rich is a great guy. I mean, we travel together, and Leonard, they get along. They can go have dinner, talk, and communicate. And I feel that's how business should go.
Floyd, you were talking earlier about cleaning up the sport. Two of your